First they gonna hate you, then they gonna celebrate you. Ba 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 ba. Hey, what's poppin', everyone? Welcome back to my spaceship. And today I'm gonna be talking about the things that I learned and the things that I didn't learn in converting my shuttle bus into an RV of some sorts, or whatever you wanna call it. So yeah, let's get started. And before you say it's not an RV, because it's older than 10 years, so I can't park it in an RV park, so it's useless. Well, yeah, you're probably right, but, you know, I'm not parked in an RV park right now, and that's okay. But you know what's not okay? You not triple-clicking the like button for the YouTube algorithm, as it won't help me a lot. So, yeah, do the opposite of that. All right, the first thing I learned was general mechanics on, you know, not the physics or the quantum mechanic kind. I already knew that stuff from college since I have a degree in physics. But what I did learn is that, you know, like screwing bolts, big bolts like stuff, because there's a lot of bolts I had to screw and unscrew in this bus. And, you know, it's a pretty simple thing. Okay, that's done. All right. The real thing that I learned was on the electronic side, not the theoretical stuff that I learned and crap that I spouted, that was spouted at me in my physics classes and my... that was kind of really just Maxwell's equations and stuff like that. No, I'm talking more about, you know, like useful kind of, electronics. Like, you know, for me, like my solar powers go into my charge controller, and that charge controller goes into my battery, and that goes into my, inverter and into my 12 volt systems, which, you know, all these lights around me, are working off of that right now. And my fridge is not actually on because I'm going to upgrade. Double my battery soon, and I don't want to like leave it off for too long, so it's just off until I get that working. Though I do want to say that the theoretical stuff I did learn in college kind of did help a little bit, you know, help ease the stress of dealing with like such a big battery. Like I have two 200 amp hour batteries, which is really big. They're lead acid, but it's way cheaper than lithium right now anyways to get that big size of battery. But I learned also a lot about the battery types, speaking on batteries. So, for example, I had to choose between lead acid and lithium. You can kind of think of lithium as what is in Tesla cars right now. Yeah. And you might be saying, why don't you use lead acid? Or why don't you use lithium if it's using Tesla? I mean, if Tesla's using it, it's got to be good, right? And yeah, it is good. It's just really expensive, kind of like Tesla's, you know. I would be living in a Tesla if I... I just don't think it's worth the money right now. That's why. Lead usually also holds, lead usually holds more for the price right now. So like if I looked at 100 amp hour lead battery and then 100 amp hour lithium battery, they would be like, the lithium would be probably like three or four times as much in terms of cost. But you have to take into consideration that the lead battery won't lasts as long, so that's why it's so much more expensive. Also, the lead, usually you should only charge it to about 50%, because if you charge it lower than that, then it's going to greatly decrease the lifespan of it. And you might be saying, but batteries are supposed to be used instead of only used up to 50%. And yeah, you're right. I mean, you could say that if you want the just like the lifespan of the battery to be gone like really quickly, but I care about my batteries just like how I care about you. Anyways, I would go with lithium again. If I had to make the choice again, I would have just like saved up more for batteries or something like that, because it's just not worth the headache of constantly looking at my phone. They have a crappy app, by the way, Renogy. Like they have a crappy app to look at the Bluetooth, because it's connected through Bluetooth. It's really crappy. Like you have to like close the app to reload the charge on the battery. It gives me a headache. I have to keep looking at it to make sure it's not less than 50%. So that's why I'm getting another one and a battery sensor. Here, I'll show you that. There we go. This battery monitor. I'm going to connect this hopefully tomorrow when there's sunlight, because I don't have many lights, so I don't know how I would do it in the dark. I guess I have a flashlight, but I'm not doing that. All right. Another major thing I learned was woodworking. And yeah, I mean, that sounds pretty simple, right? Except, you know, I was very sheltered as a child. I didn't know how to cut wood. All I knew was how to cut butter. But anyways, before working with us, I didn't know how to cut wood or use a drill. So that's why it was a big learning experience for me to make this knock on wood bed. It's probably going to fall over in my sleep one of these days. So the saw I used was just like the cheapest circular saw I found at like Home Depot. And it was much less frightening than the angle grinder, which I'll get to that story later, because I didn't see any sparks when I was using the circular saw, because there's not going to be sparks on wood. But I kind of learned how to use that. Made sure I had to read up on the proper safety needed to use that, which was, I guess, part of the learning experience, because I don't want to cut my fingers off, because that's probably the best time to cut your fingers off. Or not the best time, but I guess there's never really a best time for cutting your fingers off. I'm more talking about probably the most likely time to cut your finger off is the first time you use one of these circular saws, because it goes really fast. Just like my childhood. All right, I also learned about air ventilation. So I learned how to cut through my bus and fiberglass is really itchy. But I learned that having a fan in my roof and having it exhaust out the air, so taking it in from the front and exhausting out from the roof, is a pretty efficient way of, I guess, getting airflow compared to getting an air conditioner, which would be much more costly in terms of, voltage on my battery or charge on my battery or whatever you want to call it. Because air conditioning drains much more power. So I would probably need like three times as many batteries I have now. I have two. And I would need a lot more solar panels as well. I only have 400 amp hours or 400 watts of solar panels. And I think one of them is cracked, so I'm not even sure if that's working. But I guess we'll see in the summer. I get like 250 watts like in the middle of the day, but there's 400 watts total. So you'd think I'd get more, but then again, it is winter. So it might be fine. Maybe I'm just going crazy. I'm just expecting a lot because one's cracked. But another thing I learned is how to patch up leaks. In general. So leaks are really a big pain to deal with, I've learned. It really is depressing when it's suddenly raining and then you wake up because it's raining and then you hear dripping inside your bus, and it just infuriates me. I lost a lot of sleep due to that. I also now, like, when I hear dripping, it's probably like dripping like onto my roof. I just get nervous. Like, is it dripping in my bus? But I don't think it is anymore. Hopefully. I think I've gotten all the leaks. But the leaks were coming from my wheelchair lift door. I was like caulking on the inside, and that wasn't solving it because there's too many holes on the inside. So what I learned, I had to go into the roof, and like there's a part between the door and the the bus that like had a big hole in it, and I had to caulk that up. And yeah, that eventually solved it. There is another hole in the front, but it's honestly not in a it's not really doing anything. It's actually, the hole is above my plants. So I'm thinking maybe that'll just water my plants for me. So that's why I haven't really caulked that one yet. But it's not exactly over my plants. It's kind of like next to it. So it's not a big hole, but I might caulk that one day. The more scary holes I'm more scared of and leaks are the holes I've drilled in my roof myself with my solar panels. Because I caulked all those. I think I caulked those pretty fine. But I didn't caulk like the inside of the solar panels. Like, there's like the outside that I can get to, and then there's the inside that I can't get to. I didn't caulk the insides very well, or if at all. So I'm worried about that, like leaks into my roof, because there were leaks like directly above me, like where this emergency exit was. And I haven't seen them in a while, and it's been raining a lot here. So I think I'm good to go on leaks, hopefully. And the most important thing I learned was, this might sound cheesy, it's because it is friendship. I learned that some things you just can't do on your own. I think I spent like a whole month trying to get these seats out, you know, like just turning over and over. It would just turn infinitely because there was a bolt on the bottom. And I believe I tried it up there with like a friend, like one person holding top and one person holding bottom, and we couldn't get it until eventually I got another friend and we tried again, and that's how I got the seats out. And yeah, I couldn't have done it without that one friend. I guess I could have. I just could have gotten like, you put a wrench up there and just like kept turning it until it like hit a piece of metal, and then I would turn the bottom. But you know, you learn, you live, you learn, and that's what I learned, because I did the same thing for my wheelchair lift door. I just put like a wrench on the top and I spun the bottom, and I did that solo. So I guess what I learned is you don't need friendship. Okay, maybe, maybe. I don't know. I wouldn't have known that without friendship. So there we go. I needed it. All right, now on to what I didn't learn. And I guess I did learn what I didn't learn. So I guess I did learn that. But how to use an angle grinder effectively. Angle grinders are probably really you most like you they're a tool that is used a lot in doing these kind of conversions because it can cut metal pretty effectively. And they can grind metal, as in the name of the tool. But I bought my first angle grinder in trying to remove these bus seats because I didn't know that I could just spin the bolt out from the bottom. So I got the wrong blade for cutting it. I didn't get a cutting blade. So I couldn't rem so I tried to remove the like the old blade on the angle grinder, and I couldn't remove the old blade. So you know what? I just got it. I said, screw it, I'm getting a new angle grinder. If I don't get these seats out, I can't build this bus into a shuttle bus or into like an RV, or I can't live in this, and I had to move out really quickly. So I got a new angle grinder for like $20 from Arbor Freight, and I think I tried it on the bolts. It shot out a lot of sparks, and that honestly was really scary to me, like seeing those sparks. I think I saw the sparks originally as well, but I was too scared to use that beast of an angle grinder. Of a tool, and so I just didn't use it. I drove to Florida, where I am now, and I just got some friends, and we used the right tools for the job, I guess. So I didn't learn how to use the angle grinder effectively, and of course, actually, I did. Maybe like a month later, when I was trying to cut out a hole in my roof, I pulled out the angle grinder again because I thought it was the only tool for the job that I could have used. Maybe I could have used a saw, but I got the end grinder and I cut out a little bit of the roof, but eventually I guess I got like too deep into it and the end grinder just broke. And yeah, now it's not like it spins, but like the blade doesn't actually spin. It's not actually attached. So yeah, those are now I have two broken angle grinders. I'm just gonna replace my arms with them and I'll be a robot. But yeah, so eventually we just got a jigsaw. So I guess I learned how to use the jigsaw. But yeah, that is the story of my bus, the story of my life. I hope you learned something from this video because it is over. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll talk to you later. Peace.